The sound of the horns and the fog woke you, didn't they? You wondering what was on the other side of the window, besides louder and outside. So the deeper you go in the sheets, the better you see your last slow motion dream, where the waiter's uniform smelt of perspiration and suicide, and the dishes breaking in his eyes. Jack's throwing on the radio at 6:30 in the morning over the refrigerator another Tuesday in 1964. You swung your legs, waiting for him to finish frying the scrambled eggs. Spatula in one hand, cast iron grip in another, he said, so. The Naugahyde armrest slashed Rubicon and repaired with scotch tape, and that shadow in the chair sat pounding a pale Bloody Mary and waiting in his own mind for the applause to die down. You know how it is with some people. They want a drink. And the next thing you know, they're burying a steak knife into your furniture, trying to tell you about the lessons of Gorgo. They are vanishing Reed, the REM graduate, and the dropout from Clown College at Ringling Brothers, sharing their apartment with a shaggy mutt who was always attentive, a parrot that lists, a monkey named Stanley who can dance the jig and beg for quarters. And don't forget that rabbit in the dirty newsprint cage of mange. They move from room to room with a kind of lean-hipped devotion. He didn't believe in handing out tickets. He used to bawl them out, he said. They'll remember that better. So now he sat in a corner, nursing a drink, and wondering, while waiting for the applause to die down, thinking,